Hey everyone, welcome back. Cursor 2.0 is here and we're going to be looking at it as a first look and just giving my general opinion. I've seen a lot of videos about this and a lot of hype around it, and let's get into it. We have the normal cursor, right? You can now switch between the agent mode and the editor mode, right? This is the normal cursor that looks like VS Code, which is a fork of VS Code, right? And now we now have the new fork of both. It's not a fork of both, but come on, it looks like that. It now has a web. Okay, let me just add the web so that's browser tab. You see, with the browser tab, you now have this both feel to it, right? And the entire idea is to have a vibe coding tool for the dev community. And I think this upgrade is leaning towards even the non-technical community, right? You can now like easily switch between the editor and the agent. Apart from this UI change, you know, what else is there? Let me show you guys. One other exciting thing is the new model, the composer, right? And from the videos I've seen and remarks from the community, it's supposed to be really, really fast, even though it's almost as good as Cloud 4.5, but you know, it's supposed to be really, really fast, and that's the difference between them. Let's see, we're gonna be using the composer one just to, you know, try it out and show you guys the browser and look for that more than just the UI change. Before we proceed, I would like to talk about the sponsors of today's video, TestSprite MCP. TestSprite lets you automate testing your software product as you build, making test-driven development seamless. The MCP connects to any of the popular IDE like Visual Studio Code, Cursor, etc. It's like a QA engineer built right into your IDE, and it doesn't just check for errors, it runs full front-end and back-end tests automatically. No code, no prompts, just connect it and let it do the heavy lifting. So I give Cursor this prompt, right? Help me test this project with TestSprite. And it read my PLD, created its own test plan, and ran every test, and even showed me the visual report of what broke. Then it literally helped me fix the issues right there inside Cursor. I ran the test again, and you can see the full results in my linked video at the top of the screen. Just know that TestSprite doesn't replace your coding agent, it completes it. It takes your AI generated code and makes it production ready. If you want to try this out, I've dropped the official links in my description. So back to Cursor. So we're going to be asking you to build a wish granting one page website, and we're going to see how it fares. And the plan is hopefully we're able to preview it on the internal browser within Cursor. While that is running, let's talk about the other features, right? We now have the ability to have multiple agents running at the same time. And not just multiple agents, you can decide to use multiple models, right? Okay, so it's saying I need a Git repository. I'm going to just be initializing this project with Git. And yes, they now have a better integration to Git as one of the major updates. I'm just going to be switching back to editor mode. I'm going to be initializing this empty repository. Just that. So we can come back to the agent mode. And now I should be able to see, we still have the other agents running. I should set up a new agent and make it work with multiple models. From having multiple models, you can select which of the models you want it to use, and you can select how many times you want it to run. I think I wanted to do this one time and this one time, right? So this is another great thing. Sometimes, when IT supports, when you say, oh, my laptop's not working, they say, have you restarted it? Same thing. Sometimes just running the exact same prompt a second time can be the solution you need, give you a different result, and we can have the opportunity to test that here, right? So you can give a prompt and make it run the prompt twice. Another thing, you can actually select which branch you would like to work on, if it's the local or the work tree. Let's just use the work tree. It's just think about the idea of the way you have your main branch, you branch out of it, you write your code. If it's a code is accepted or not, you can merge it into the main branch. Think about it with that mindset. Yeah, if we give a prompt, the model is going to run the prompt across the two different models, right? Times the number of times we want it to run. Another cool feature that I've seen is the voice, right? And I think it's something that I'm going to use a lot, because yes, I am a lazy developer. But let's just test it out. I do have an intonation, so let's see how good it is. We know there's, so far we've heard about so many really, really nice text-to-speech out there. But, sorry, speech-to-text. Let's see what they have and how good is it. Is it going to be accurate? Nothing's happening. So how accurate is it going to be? Because I know I do have an intonation. And let's see how it's accurate it's going to be. So I would stop this so I could just like check out the results. So see how good it is. So far, we've heard so many really, really nice text-to-speech out there. But speech-to-text, yeah, I did myself. Let's see what... So we can see it's quite accurate. It's quite accurate, right? Let's just give it a real prompt. Can you improve the UI of the Wish website? I want something like liquid glass that Apple has. Something really, really nice. See, that's quite nice. I will just be copying this in case because I have trust issues while I switch back to this chat. And I think this is done and we should be able to preview the site, right? So let's just see. I would like to see the code. They're all just normal HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. I feel like even though I have my agents here, I should still have my file. I don't know. I should still have my files because I keep switching back to the editor just because I want to see this view. I feel like that's something that is missing. If you know how to make that show on the same page, maybe because I have a big screen, so I have enough space, but if you know how to make that show, please tell me in the comment section so I don't have to switch back to the editor anytime I need to see my list of files. But yeah, this is a simple plain HTML, CSS, and JavaScript, and I would like to just open that here and open with live server. Let's open the browser we linked, browser tab, and I will just paste the live server URL. Let's make some adjustments so we can see it in its full glory. So this is it. Nice purple color happening here. A nice animation. Let's see how it plans to execute granting a wish. Write a wish. I want to be rich. Yes, I want to be rich. Nice, nice. I want 1 million subs on YouTube. Now, so I was going to explain to you guys, to show you guys the difference between having, because you know, Visual Studio Code already has an extension that let you have a browser within Visual Studio Code. But this is way just more than just an extension, right? I'm going to be showing you why. What does it bring to the table? You see, we have this inspect tool here that allows you, you know, inspect different elements of the site and then take it to Cursor, right? I want to tell Cursor that, maybe, you know, okay, let's just say, can you improve? You can see Cursor actually shows the selected text area, right? And I can select something different. Yeah. Can you improve this element, right? This is something, except you have an MCP before, you would not be able to do. And I think it's really cool. Before I submit that prompt, I also want to show you guys the terminal. And you see, not just the terminal, the console, actually. When you make changes and you console log them, it's going to be able to see the changes you make and, you know, that you have console log. So that not just debugging UI, this actually also helps you debug the actual logic of the code. I think it's a really great update and it really makes a huge difference for full stack developers. Yeah. Of course, it's supposed to be also be for non-technical people. So yeah. And I think we can all see the Composer One model in works. I think it's just so far. It's not so different from the, you know, 4.5 we have from Cloud Sonnet. And just like that, we can see it's done. We can see it now made changes to the placeholder text that is here. And also we can see this whole, like, it's really nice, right? It's now changing. So we can see how you can select stuff and send to the LLM, unlike before your normal browser. So let's review the changes and just keep all of them, right? Then next, we can now try the multiple agents, like I said. So yeah, we're going to be trying the two different agents and seeing the results. There's no need to bore you with the results of the edits, but as we can see, these same features actually allow us to run multiple agents simultaneously, and I think it's a huge game changer. If there's any feature I forgot to cover in my video, please do leave a comment and let me know. All right, thank you guys. See you guys next time.